I guess you probably think that I'm gonna use flow frames on this tutorial. The software turns a fucking 5 FPS video into a smooth-ass 60 FPS video. But no, it's taken me ages just to twixter a single 2 seconds clip, and I just found a way to do it only in After Effects. So want this?
Hi everyone, it's me, Amzun2K6 here. So recently I have been, you know, looking up for a good twister setting for some of my anime edit because I find my twister setting looking bad as fuck. And then I just realized that different anime have different ways of animated as well as the frame rate. That's why I realized that most of the twister setting tutorial on YouTube is just, you know, a bit of shit and it's not even working at all. So today I just found a little article on Reddit talking about twister. I'm gonna leave the link right down in the description as well. It's very known, but it's also teaching you guys every single thing that you need to know about twister, so make sure to check it out. So today I'm gonna be teaching you guys about my twister setting. I know that some of you guys are gonna be talking about flow frames, which is a software that, you know, is made the ABS of the clip from 23 to even 240, which I also have over there. I have been test some of the method with it and it's working really well for me. But this is one problem. It's really slow on my PC for some reason, I don't know why, and it's also take a lot of time to the twister. That's a fucking 1 second clip to make a fucking AMV edit, so I don't really think that it is a good method. So today I'm gonna be teaching you guys a method that is not my own as well. It's from the article that I just read it. I also leave the links, you know, the donate link of the original owner, because, you know, it's really known, it's really useful for me. So yeah, now let's get right into the tutorial. So for this tutorial, what we're gonna do is we need to look at the basic information of the clip that you wanted to twister. So here the clips have the frame rates of 23 by 976 ABS. So you need to make sure that the ABS of the original clips as well as the composition that you wanna be at the twister effect on have the same frame rate. And for the size, actually need to contain it. So yeah, once you've done this, we're gonna be pre-compose this. So the reason why I'm pre-compose this one, because sometimes when you try to make the speed down, you know, about 60 and you're not pre-compose, the clip, the scene gonna be changed. So that's why I need to pre-compose. I'm just gonna name this one original clips. And hit okay. Once you've done this, what we're gonna do next is we're gonna straight up add Twister Bro into the clip. So the first thing here is UZPU. This one on the band on the PC, I'm just gonna set to the third one. The odd motion sort and odd color sort and odd motion sorts. This one is pretty complicated. Maybe I'm gonna make an advanced tutorial next week. But yeah, today I'm just gonna teach you guys some basic thing and how to fix the warping first. So the next thing that we're gonna be looking at is in ABS, out ABS. You're gonna turn this one off, and for the most important setting, the frame rates, we're just gonna leave it there. We're gonna be talking about that later. So for the input field, sometimes I'm using upper field first because it's looking pretty good, but yeah, maybe I'm just gonna temporarily set it at long. For the chart control, we're gonna set the image rep to contact and is enhanced. Chart RPG plus A, we're gonna be turning this one on because, you know, it's gonna be chart the motion. And for the speed, it's just gonna leave it at 100s. We're gonna, you know, play around with that later. And for the image prep, we're gonna change motion grid blend, and for the warping, you're gonna change that to forwards. So now, once you've done the basic setting for twister, that is, you know, most of the time it's always stay on this setting. Now we're gonna be looking up at input frame rate. As you can see, the input frame rate here is 20 live by 0.97, which is not right. So now we need to look at the ABS of the composition. As you can see, it's the same as the original clip, 23 by 907 967. Holy fucking god, why am I so bad at this? We're just gonna temporarily set it at this frame rate. We're gonna change it more later. Now we need to click on the layer that you wanted to working on, and you need to count what is actually the real, you know, the actual frame rate of this clip. Because you don't, when you see an anime clip, you know, animated in 23 fps, it's not mean that it's animated in 23 fps. Sometimes some of the objects in the scene have different fps, different speed. So you know, you need to count that to see what it actually is the real fps of the clip. So now to do that, we're gonna click on the clip right there, or you can use Twister script that I'm gonna use on my later tutorial. I'm not gonna use this today because it's way too complicated, and I don't really think that some beginner, when you guys watching this video, can understand this. So click on the layer, pick up 1, 2, 3, and you can see the hair, it changes. And you can see 1, 2, 3. Now keep doing this, 1, 2, 3, the hair changes again. 1, 2, 3, the hair changes again. And if it still changes every 3 fps, now we're gonna try that for the last time, 1, 2, 3, and you can see the hair changes again. It means that the main object that you're trying to, you know, focus on, it changes every 3 fps. So now we're gonna click, we're gonna use the original fps of the clip, divide that to 3, so that we're gonna have the original frame rate of the clip of 7.989. So once you've done this, what we're gonna do next is we're gonna be looking up at the difference. So here you basically the difference, this is without Twister bro, as you can see it's gonna be looking like this. And now this is with Twister bro, a very big difference, as you can see right over there. So even if you speed down the clip, maybe 60, it's also gonna be looking smooth as fuck bro. Look at this, how sexy it is. This is the biggest difference, you know, when you're trying to on different to, I mean, it's, why I'm so bad at it right now. But yeah, basically it is, okay? So when you've done this, as you can see, we have a really, really good Twister right there. But this is one more problem, and you can see that the hair around here, it still have some, you know, small warping, as you can see. So to fix this, actually there is a very simple way that you can fix this warping thing. It is using Chalkboy, which is right over there. So for the Chalkboy, you need to turn it off the Twister bro, so that, you know, you need to turn it in off so that it's gonna be played on original speed. And now you're gonna look at the part that you wanted to stop it from fucking warping. You're gonna click on Chalkboy, click on the plate that is, you know, got warped. And then what we're gonna do is you're gonna chalking it. So here I'm just gonna find a little fucking pieces because I don't want it to, you know, wait you guys time actually. So yeah, maybe I'm just gonna do this hair right there. But when you done this, you know, when you turning this one off, you're gonna click on the position, make a keyframe, and click beta on the keyboard to actually track the hair. You know, you need to track the boy like this. Alright, still gonna stay. Just gonna track that. It's gonna take a lot of time, so I'm just gonna simply, you know, speed up this part. You can click on the layer, click U to see all the keyframes as well. Now I'm gonna speed this one up. Thank you. So once you've done everything, and you can see the boy got chocolate really good over there, what we're gonna do next is we're gonna be turning on Twister Bro again. And what we're gonna do here, I'm just gonna set the speed back to 100 so that you're gonna see where the warping part, like this part right there, as you can see, it's a bit warping. So to fix this, we're just gonna click from the ease right there, don't use the FG1. It's give a little difference, as you can see, this one right there and this one right there. So to do this, also we're gonna change the motion sensitivity to 100. Yeah, when you've done that, it's gonna be looking a bit less twistery night. You know, it's gonna be looking less warping, and you can see right there, it's less, much less warping than, you know, before and after. Actually, it's much less warping. So here is the preview, as you can see, it's less warping. So when you've done this, what we're gonna do next is you can add some RSMB to have some lateral motion blur. That's RSMB. I'm just gonna use longbow RSMB. You can play around with a blur, maybe one need too much, but here I'm just focused on the, you know, the twister. So maybe one is pretty much one edit, you know, because you're gonna ask RSMB later as well, but here I'm just gonna be focused on the clips, so I'm gonna be asked RSMB anyway. As you can see, here is after looking good, right? Now what we're gonna move into the second example. So there's a thing that's happened a lot of time, it is type warping when the objects move from the bottom up, you know, it's not over there, it's like this. So I'm using the same clip, the same element, so probably it's still, you know, stay, it's gonna be changed every 3 frames. Oh, this one is just like, you know, fucking freezing. It's still 3. And let's make a quick thing for you guys. But we're just gonna do the same thing here. I'm just gonna making it very quick. Oh shit, I forgot. So now when we done this, we're just gonna be taking a look at the warping scene, which is over there. As you can see, we got some warping, but the warping thing that I'm trying to talking about here is some kind of layer that, you know, it's got some kind of lie over there. It's pretty hard to explain actually, because, you know, it's pretty hard for me. So what we're gonna fix here is we're gonna add motion title on top of it to actually extend the size of the clip. As you can see, on the scale this one down, the reason why, because the hand over there is not showing up there, and over there is showing up, which means that is the twister cannot track, you know. So to do it, to fix this, just set this one as 125 by 125. That's maybe enough for me. And yeah, it's gonna be extended clip as well, so that's how to fix a little warping. So yeah, for the eye as well, it's gonna be on a future tutorial. So today it is some basic tutorial for Adobe After Effects. I really hope that you guys are gonna be enjoying my tutorial, and see you guys in tomorrow tutorial. I really need idea right now because I need to work on a lot of different channel right now. So I really hope that you guys could help me about that. So yeah, see ya.